Well, the name of this show is Real Estate Investing with Jay Connor. So I suppose we should spend a couple of minutes anyway talking about real estate investing specifically. So, you know, you're still a very active real estate investor yourself. You know what's going on in the market. And I don't know about you, Alex, but Carol Joy, my wife and I, we have been full-time real estate investors since 2003. So we're now into the 18th year of this. And in these years, I never before have I found it more challenging to actually find the deals, right? For more than one reason. Number one, there's no inventory, right? Mm-hmm. And we're not going to rely, and I never have, but we're not going to rely, and we can't rely on the multiple listing service. Cause there's nothing in there, right? There's no deals.
Right.
Now foreclosures are starting to open up and, you know, you'll see a bank owned property in there every now and then starting up. But my question to you is in this economy, mm-hmm. in this market where, well, first of all, I don't want to assume, would you agree that it is more challenging to find deals today and we have to find them in different or more ways, say, than we did a couple of years ago?
That's a tough question to answer. I think it can be more challenging, but I think we just have to adapt. And I think we have to, you know, so what the marketing that we were doing 12, 18, 24 months ago might not be as effective now. And so I think it's really a matter of I hate to use the word pivot because that's so overused, but we have to shift, right? And so while one of the things I like to do when it comes to marketing is when people are fishing in this pond, I like to figure out other ponds that people just haven't discovered. I remember years ago, cold calling became very popular, but there was a handful of people that really discovered cold calling before it became popular. And then it was ringless voicemails. And then it was SMS marketing. And now SMS marketing is becoming more challenging because of certain laws and regulations. What I find, Jay, and I've had conversations with mutual friends about this, is that the more competitive and challenging finding deals becomes, the more archaic effective marketing is. And what I mean by that is, you know, while I would love to be on your show here and sharing the next greatest, sexiest way to generate leads and close deals, direct mail, you know, things like that still work. The question is, do you work? Are you going to remain consistent? You know, are you putting all your eggs into one marketing channel, or do you have at least two or three? And are you consistently testing, tracking, tweaking, and improving on your marketing channels? So I think it can be more challenging, but one of the things I have found to be most effective when it comes to marketing is, regardless of what marketing you're doing, I would prefer to go an inch wide and a mile deep. And what I mean by that is be consistent and committed to your marketing. Whatever that is, consistently do it. And then don't just be lazy. You know, one of the things that, you know, when I was running the wholesaling operation, we had a swipe file. So when my acquisition manager would go meet with the seller, I would always see if they could collect the direct mail pieces. And 99.9% of the copy all said the same exact thing. We buy houses with cash, as is, we pay your closing cost. And I like to separate ourselves. So when people are zigging, you want to zag. And so we attempted to make our direct mail pieces very personable. We didn't even allude to, hey, we can close quickly. Because guess what? What if they don't want to close quickly? You know, so figure out how you can separate yourself from the competition, and copying your marketing is just one of many ways to do that. Mm-hmm.